So, I just wanted to make a little more casual video of some GCC figures I've gotten recently, but feel like I don't have any room for in my next GCC video. So take this video as kind of the October wave review, plus some. First, let's talk about this Jocasta new minifigure. Now, there was a little bit of buzz around this figure because it seemed so out of place, but this is the exact type of figure I want to see GCC make more of. I love filling out background characters, and especially when they're so well done. The skirt printing on this figure is just great. GCC has been doing a lot of printed skirts recently, and I love to see it. The only thing kinda off about this Jocasta is that the eyes seem to be a little too large, at least compared to official LEGO minifigures. It looks not great on camera, but in hand it's a lot less noticeable. Two of my favorite clones also got helmets, Waxer and Boyle. I love when GCC does these sort of upgrade pieces, which I'll go into more sometime in the future. But I love that they've updated the orange paint to match more closely to LEGO's orange. So when you put these replacement helmets on, it just blends so perfectly. I also finally got their Fox replacement torso that fixes all of the issues I have with that figure. Now he's perfect enough for Vader to crush his windpipe. And finally, I've gotten the two clones I kept missing out on since I got into GCC, Jesse and Hardcase. Like any other person diagnosed with clone trooper brain rot, I love the Umbara arc of the Clone Wars, and I will take any chance to build out that 501st squad. I mean, the first Phase 2 custom clone action figures that I ever made were the Umbara squad. So now, having these three OGs and Apo, I just couldn't be happier with how my minifigure collection is coming along. Just like Kix in my previous video, these two come with great arm printing, and it really makes them stand out. Hardcase's arms could even be used for regular grunts if you want to roll like that. Now, as you can see, this is why I didn't make a full video for the October wave, because I really didn't get enough from it to warrant a full video. Just enough to make this short video before the massive, and I mean massive, November drop. I'll catch y'all sometime in late December to review that wave. Later.